U.S. military in Iran. Shalom, first and foremost, giving all praises, honor, glory, respect, and blessings to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai, Bashem Rachakwadash. Salutations to the Lord's elect on the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth and sincerity while patiently waiting for Yahweh Shai's return. And double honors to our apostles and elders, the great millstone, which have taught us everything we know through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Bashem, Yahweh Shai. And I just wanted to do a quick update, letting you brothers know that there are U.S. militaries, that the United States have a military in Iran. Now we know that according to the book of Jeremiah, chapter 50, verse 45, we know that the United States plays a key role in setting off World War III. Just a moment. Okay, we know that the United States plays a key role in setting off World War III. So here it says, Iran's military forces are made up of, So here it says, the Pentagon has directed about 4,500 troops in the region atop the roughly 50,000 already there. So now this was almost a year and 6 days ago. Or maybe even seven, because sometimes some of these months be having an extra day to it and shit. So you could say maybe a year and six days ago, or maybe a year and 7 days ago. It depends. But, you know, the Pentagon has directed about 4,500 troops to the region atop the roughly 50,000 already there. So this was a year and 6 days ago, or roughly a year and 6 days ago. Which means how much more now, you know, because the United States, they're not going to keep people updated on how many troops they are sending to the region. You know, so maybe there's more than 70,000 troops there. Maybe there's more than 90,000 troops there. As tensions rise with Iran. So tensions has been rising with Iran since a year and roughly 6 days ago. So you can only imagine that tensions between the United States and Iran are at an all-time high. It says they are reinforcing their outposts, bases, and airfields. So they also have warplanes there too. So you could better understand. Now if we scroll down here, right? Where is the United States Army base located in Iran? And down here, they tell you the district is Doma. Okay, here they say Al-Tanf. And then here they, the district is Doma. So Al-Tanf, the district of Doma. Sub-district Al-Sabe, Bayar. Al-Sabe Bayar region, Al-Tanf pocket. So this is where their base is located at. So the United States have troops in Iran. Now if we type in, let's go to Habakkuk real quick. Okay. Chapter 2, verse 5. It says Habakkuk. Chapter 2, verse 5. Yea, also because he transgresseth by wine, he is a proud man, neither keepeth at home. You know? So it's clear at this point that the United States military is stretching themselves thin. They are stretching themselves really, really thin. You see? because they got military bases on the southern borders of Europe. They got military bases in South Korea. They got troops in South Korea. They got troops on the southern borders of Europe. You know, they got troops in the Middle East. They got troops in Syria. They got troops down there in Africa. Okay, they got naval ships over by Taiwan, by the artificial islands of China. So it's clear to say that the United States is stretching themselves thin. So they never keepeth at home. And that's the key point there. Now let's go to Jeremiah 50 verse 45. Therefore hear ye the counsel of the Lord that he have taken against Babylon. Babylon, which is the United States of America, and his purposes that he had proposed against the land of the Chaldeans. Okay, your modern day Chaldeans today will be the Illuminati. Surely the least of the flock shall draw them out. Who's the least of the flock? The so-called Israelis are the least of the flock. They're the ones going around telling the world that they are the flock of the Lord. Okay, telling the world they're Jewish, and they're not. Okay, they're not Jewish. They are descendants of Esau. Okay, they descend from Amalek. Amalek is a descendant of Esau. So it says, so the so-called Israelis. It says, surely the least of the flock shall draw them out, meaning the Israelis shall draw out the United States of America into their confrontation against Iran, which is going to be the spark of World War III. Surely he shall make their habitation desolate with them. Okay? Yeah, make their habitation desolate, because not only is the United States of America going to be a desolate country, but the land of Israel is going to be made desolate through the nuclear catastrophe, because the main targets of the coming nuclear war is going to be the United States of America and the land of Israel. With that, I'm going to say shalom, is on to the next one.